Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about the news from the Hindu newspaper of 14th May, which are specifically designed for the prelims as well as mains, UPSC and for the others competitive examinations. And if you are preparing for any government examinations, you can visit our websites exammap.com and isbio.com, and you can also contact us on our WhatsApp number. So let's start the video. First topic is Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002, which is also known as PMLA. So the this act, Prevention of Money Laundering Act, enacted in 2002 and it came into force in 2005. The objective of this act is to fight with money laundering. And what is the meaning of money laundering? That is the process of converting black money into the white, means the corrupting money back into the white or the legal manner. This act enables government authorities to confiscate property or any assets earned from the illegal sources through money laundering. Means by this act, government authorities can take under themselves the property or the assets of any illegal sources that came from the money laundering. And the burden of proof lies with the accused, who has to prove that suspect property and assets have not obtained through the proceeds of the crime. And there is also a provision that applicable to all financial institutions, banks including RBI, mutual funds, insurance companies and their financial intermediaries. These are the areas which comes under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act. Second topic is National Mission for Clean Ganga. So the National Mission for Clean Ganga is the implementation wing of National Council for Rejuvenation, Protection and Management of River Ganga, which is also referred as National Ganga Council, and it is established in the year 2011, which is registered under the Societies Registration Act 1860, and it has two-tier management structure and comprises of Governing Council and Executive Committee. So the two-tier management structure is Governing Council and Executive Committee, and both of these tiers headed by the Director General of National Mission Clean Ganga. And Executive Committee is authorized to approve project under mission up to rupees 1,000 crore. And similar to this structure at national level, State Programs Management Groups acts as the implementing arm of Ganga committees, and this structure attempts to bring all stakeholders on one platform to take holistic approach towards the task of Ganga cleaning and rejuvenation of the Ganga. And in October 2016, National Ganga Council has replaced National Ganga River Basin Authority, which was constituted under the provision of Environment Protection Act 1986. Next topic is National Cadet Corps. National Cadet Corps or NCC formed in 1948 on the recommendation of H.N. Kunru Committee, which was formed in 1946, and this NCC formed in 1948. And it has the roots to the British era uniform. Youth entities like University Corps, University Officer Training Corps. Currently, it has the strength of around 40 lakh cadets from Army, Navy and Air Force wings. एंड एनसीसी फॉल्स अंडर द पर्व्यू ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ डिफेंस एंड इट इज़ हेडेड बाय डायरेक्टर जनरल ऑफ 3-star मिलिट्री रैंक. मीन्स दैट पर्सन विच हैज़ 3-star इज हेडेड दिस एनसीसी एंड इट एनरोल्स कैडेट्स एट द हाई स्कूल एंड कॉलेज लेवल ऑल्सो एंड अवार्ड्स द सर्टिफिकेट ऑन द कम्प्लीशन ऑफ वेरियस फेसेस एंड द एनसीसी कैडेट रिसीव बेसिक मिलिट्री ट्रेनिंग एट वेरियस लेवल्स and also have academic curriculum basic related to armed forces and their functioning. And in this NCC cadets, it includes various training camps, adventure activities, military training camps are the important aspects of NCC training. Next topic is cloudburst. Cloudburst is a localized weather phenomena representing highly concentrated rainfall over a small area lasting for few hours. Means over a small area, the highly concentrated rainfall over a small area lasting for few hours. And this leads to a flash floods, landslides, house collapse, dislocation of traffic and human casualties on a large scale. Meteorologists say the rain from a cloudburst is usually of shower type with a fall rate equal to the greater than 100 millimeter per hour. So how this cloudburst form? Generally cloudbursts are associated with thunderstorms and the air currents rushing upwards in a rainstorm hold up and a large amount of water, and if these currents suddenly cease means releasing from that cloud of the heavy water, entire amount of water descends onto a small area with a catastrophic force all of a sudden and causes a mass destruction. And this is due to rapid condensation of clouds, means continuously happening the condensation of the clouds, and they occur most often in desert and mountainous areas and in the interior regions of continental landmasses. What are the prone areas? Means the areas affected by this cloud burst, first and foremost the desert and mountainous regions and the interior regions of continental landmasses, and the topographical conditions like steep hills favor the formation of these clouds in the mountainous regions, and also the devastations as water flowing down the steep slopes bring debris, boulders and uprooted trees with great velocity and damage any structure that comes in their ways. Chota Nagpur Plateau spread across north of Odisha, West Bengal and Jharkhand is the world's most vulnerable spot for the formation of severest thunderstorms. So Chota Nagpur Plateau, which covers 3 states of India, that is Odisha, West Bengal and Jharkhand, is the world's most vulnerable spot for the thunderstorming. And cloud burst can occur not only in monsoon seasons but also during March to May, which is the summer season and known for severe convective weather activities. So can we have the predictions of the cloudbursts? So about the predictions, large scale features which are conducive for the occurrence of severe thunderstorms associated with the cloudburst. So if we have a severe thunderstorm, occurrence of severe thunderstorm, so we can have the idea of the cloudburst, and predictable 2 to 3 days in advance. However, specific location and time of cloudburst can be predicted in nowcast mode only, that is few hours in advance, and when the genesis of thunderstorm has already commenced, means thunderstorm has already done. At that time, only in few hours, we can predict it of the cloudburst. To detect these sudden developments, डोपलर वेदर रडार. डोपलर वेदर रडार विच इज़ अ पावरफुल टूल फॉर द टाइम एंड लोकेशन स्पेसिफिक प्रिडिक्शन ऑफ क्लाउड बर्स्ट. सो यू कैन लर्न दिस टर्म डोपलर वेदर रडार विच इज़ यूज फॉर द फॉर टाइम एंड लोकेशन स्पेसिफिक प्रिडिक्शन ऑफ क्लाउड बर्स्ट कैन बी डेवलप्ड अ फ्यू आवर्स इन एडवांस एंड कपल्ड विद सैटेलाइट्स इमेजिनरी दिस कैन प्रूव टू बी यूजफुल इनपुट्स फॉर एक्सट्रापोलेशन of cloudbursts anywhere in the India. So now we have a term which is thunderstorm. So what is thunderstorm? Thunderstorms and tornadoes are severe local storms. They are of short duration, occurring over a small area, but are violent. Thunderstorm is a storm with thunder and lightning, typically also heavy rain or hail. They mostly occur on the ground where temperature is very high and they are less frequent on water bodies due to low temperature. So this means the thunder we have, occurring of thunderstorm is on land. Land has a high temperature and on the water bodies, we have no thunderstorm because of low temperature. And worldwide, there are estimated 16 million thunderstorms each year and at any moment. And there are roughly 2,000 thunderstorms in a progress. So, what is the path of the thunderstorm? A path of a thunderstorm is erratic, means in a straight line. Motion is primarily due to the interaction of updrafts and downdrafts, and the speed of isolated storms is typically about 20 km per hour, but some storms are much faster, and in extreme circumstances, a supercell storm may move from 65 to 80 km per hour. What is downburst? As downdrafts referred to as macroburst or microburst. So the macroburst is more than 4 km in diameter and can produce winds as high as 60 meters per second or 250 km per hour. And microburst is a smaller in dimension but produces winds as high as 75 meters per second. It has the it is producing winds 75 meter per second, which is larger than the macroburst, and they are seriously hazardous to aircrafts, especially during takeoffs and landings. Next topic is zero rated supplies. So what is zero rated supplies? This is a mean supply of goods and services or both to SEZ or SEZ developer or export of goods or services or both. SEZ is a specific economic zone and GST is not applicable in India for exports. Hence, all export supplies of a taxpayer registered under GST would be classified as zero rated supply. So what is the meaning of zero rated supply? That the exports of the country India is not applicable in GST. So the all export supplies of taxpayer registered under GST would be classified as zero rated supply. The taxpayer can claim the input tax credits or claim the refund of unutilized input tax credit. And zero rated supply means any of the following supplies of goods or services. These are exports of goods or services or both, supply of goods or services or both to a special economic zone developer, and supply of goods or services or both to a special economic zone unit. Next topic is ORISIS RX. It is a NASA's origins special interpretation resource identification security regolith explorer. So the full form of ORISIS RX is origin spectral interpretation resource identification security regolith explorer. In October 2020, a spacecraft briefly touched asteroid Bennu, from where it collected the sample of dust and pebbles. It is NASA's first mission meant to return a sample from ancient asteroid, and the mission is essentially a 7-year-long voyage. Will conclude when at least 60 grams of samples are delivered back to the Earth. So as per the NASA, the mission promises to bring the largest amount of extraterrestrial material back to our planet since the Apollo era. Mission was launched in 2016 and it reached its target in 2018, and since then the spacecraft have trying to match the velocity of asteroid using small rocket thrusters, and spacecraft contains 5 instruments to mean to explore Bennu, including cameras, spectrometer and laser altimeter. So the asteroid Bennu is what is asteroid? So asteroids are rocky subjects that orbit sun much smaller than planets, and Bennu is an asteroid about as tall as Empire State Building, located about 200 million miles away from the Earth. The Bennu asteroid discovered by a team from NASA, which funded Lincoln Near Earth Asteroid Research Team in 1999, and it is believed to have been born in main asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. The asteroid is coming closer to Earth because of gravitational tugs, and it comes is from other celestial bodies, and slight push asteroids get when they release the absorbed sunlight. Next topic is World Food Prize 2021. So the World Food Prize 2021 is the foremost international honor recognizing achievement of individuals who have advanced human development by improving quality, quantity or availability of food in the world. It is an annual award that recognizes contribution in any field involved in the world food supply, including plant, animal and soil science, and food science and technology, nutrition, rural development, etc. It is open for any individual without regard to race, religion, nationality and political beliefs. In addition to the cash award of $250,000, and the laureate receives a sculpture designed by the noted artist and designer Saul Bass. So the presentation of award is it is presented each October on or around United Nations World Food Day, that is on 16th October, and it is presented by World Food Prize Foundation, which has over 80 companies, individuals, etc. as donors. The World Food Prize Foundation is located in Des Moines, USA. Sheikh Zayed Book Award. So this award is a literary award begin in UAE, and the award is named after the Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan, who was the first president of UAE when the Federation of Seven Sectums became a country in 1971. While describing itself as independent initiative, the prize is administered by Abu Dhabi Culture and Tourism Authority, and the cultural person of the year is the premier category. It includes an award of 1 million dirhams, while the other categories receive around $200,000 each. And the author of this award is Habermas was named cultural personality of the year and distinction that carries a cash prize of 1,000,000 dirhams. Next topic is business responsibility and sustainability report. So the regulator of business responsibility and sustainability report is SEBI came out with disclosure requirement under business responsibility and sustainability reporting covering environmental, social and governance perspectives, which will be able on the top 1,000 listed entities by market capitalization. You just learn about the report that the business responsibility and sustainability report released by the SEBI. Next topic is National Human Rights Commission. So the National Human Rights Commission established in 1993 and it is in conformity with the Paris principles adopted at the first international workshop on the National Institutions for the Protection of Human Rights held in Paris in 1991. It is a statutory organization established under the Protection of Human Rights Act 1993, and the headquarters of NHRC is in New Delhi. Functions of NHRC is that the purpose of the NHRC is suo moto, means it takes actions itself without getting any plea by someone or through the petition of a person or to investigate the violation of human rights of the failures of the state other to prevent a human rights violation. The commission may also take on research about human rights, create awareness campaigns through various mediums and encourage the work of NGOs. So the composition of NHRC is, it consists of one chairman, 4 full-time members and 4 deemed person members, and the statute lays down qualification for the appointment of chairperson and members of the commission that the chairperson should be a retired Chief Justice of India. Next topic is Competition Commission of India, CCI. Competition Commission of India is a statutory body responsible for the enforcing objectives of CCI Act 2002, and it has been established by central government with the effect from 14th October 2003. It has one chairperson plus 6 members appointed by a central government, and it has the amendment that was done in Competition Amendment Act 2007, and it follows the philosophy of modern competitive laws that the act prohibits anti-competitive agreements, abuse of dominant position by enterprises, and regulates combinations which causes or likely to cause an appreciable adverse effect on competition within the India. So these are the current affairs of 14th May. We will back with the next day current affairs. Thank you, class.